Championship Boxing.
Special presentation of HBO Sports, the network of champions.
Tonight, welterweight champion Felix Trinidad invites you to a party. Join Tito and 10,000 of his closest friends at Roberto Clemente Coliseum in Trinidad's native Puerto Rico for a festival which will knock your socks off. Overcame several obstacles before knocking out Obakar in the 11th round. Can Felix Trinidad also stay on course toward a possible showdown in September? Stay tuned to find out. San Juan, Puerto Rico, for another edition of World Championship Boxing. Tonight, welterweight champion Felix Trinidad, a native of this tropical island, fights in front of more than 10,000 hugely partisan fans against relatively unknown challenger Hugo Pineda of Colombia. In Puerto Rico, there are two San Juans, the old one with its 16th and 17th century charm, and the new San Juan, modern, busy, bustling. Tonight, we enter Roberto Clemente Coliseum, named after the most graceful and generous of all Puerto Rican athletes. Here, Felix Trinidad is still but a blip on the graph compared with the touch of royalty named Clemente, but with a win tonight and with a win over Oscar De La Hoya perhaps as early as September of this year, Trinidad might begin to touch Puerto Ricans in just exactly the same way. Hello again, everybody. I'm Jim Lampley. We welcome you to this showcase edition of HBO's World Championship Boxing. An unusual time for us, 11 o'clock Eastern time. Only one fight to be shown to you tonight. That's become unusual, as most of our cards now contain at least two fights. And certainly a showcase, as the piece of business at hand here tonight is Felix Trinidad with a lightly regarded challenger for his version of the welterweight title. Trinidad trying to do what Oscar De La Hoya did against Obakar last week. Clear away the last remaining competitive obstacle to a mega fight showdown with De La Hoya, perhaps to come this fall, September 18. Working with me as always, HBO boxing analyst Larry Merchant. And frankly, Larry and I are a little lonely tonight because George Foreman was already booked up before this fight hit the schedule. And Larry, let's take a look at where George was today. While he wasn't in Puerto Rico, he was in Wrigley Field in Chicago.
Or one, or two, or three. Oh, take me out to the ball game. Take me out for the band. Buy me some peanuts and Cracker Jack.
Root for the company. They don't win it.
a lot of day jobs, none of them threatened by that afternoon excursion to Chicago, but what heart, huh?
Yeah, I have to sing, take us out to the prize fights, take us out to the hype, buy me a sanctioning body.
And go no further, Larry, as we get ready to move toward one of those fights which is meaningful with or without sanctioning bodies, the possible mega fight showdown this fall between De La Hoya and Trinidad, for which all the circumstances now seem to be set. Last few remaining details of negotiations still to be taken care of, but maybe, just maybe, it's going to happen. What chance is there, however, that the relatively unknown Hugo Pineda of Colombia could bust the De La Hoya Trinidad Pinata wide open tonight?
Well, I don't think he's really capable of pulling off a Buster Douglas. The talk in San Juan is that if anybody can bust up that mega showdown, it would be Trinidad and his manager father. And depending on your view, either they're making outrageous demands or they're being very firm, tough negotiators. Be that as it may, as for Pineda, he's very tall, he's got very sharp elbows, he's got a decent punch, and he's got a decent record, a good record, in fact. But to beat this man here in his hometown, he'd have to knock him out twice to get a draw.
So the deal isn't finalized, but assuming a Trinidad victory over Pineda here tonight, as everyone in this arena surely does, are we going to see, on a scale of 1 to 10, with 10 being absolutely and 1 being no way, what is the chance we'll see De La Hoya Trinidad?
Well, it's probably a 9, Jim. It should be a 10 or an 11.
And maybe soon it will be. Let's take a look at the tail of the tape now for Felix Trinidad against Hugo Pineda. And Larry pointed out Pineda's height. Trinidad, at 5'11", is in no way accustomed to fighting opponents taller than himself. Pineda has a 2-inch height advantage. And look at the weights. They weighed in 30 hours ago at 147 pounds. And Larry, we're told that within an hour of the weigh-in, Pineda weighed 163.
Two more pounds and he'd be a light heavyweight. That's the record that we have seen so far for a dried out, dehydrated fighter adding weight by drinking a lot of water.
And punch that numbers, Larry.
You can see from this that Pineda is a pretty active fighter. He'll take a lot of swings, hoping that he hits somebody, as he did against Costazu, and sometimes he does.
Rules of the bout with our unofficial ringside scorer, Harold Letterman.
The Felix Trinidad Hugo Pineda fight is scheduled for 12 rounds using the unified rules of the Association of Boxing Commissions. The notable rule tonight is the no free knockdown rule. Larry, with two big punches in the ring and a huge hometown advantage for Felix Trinidad, we really want to see how much the hometown crowd will influence the referee if we get a whole lot of knockdowns scored by either guy in the same round. Jim!
All right, and Hugo Pineda is already in the ring as this raucous crowd salutes the arrival of Felix Trinidad in just a few minutes. There's a look at Pineda, 36 wins, one loss. That was to the well-known Costazu, and a draw, 27 KOs. All this, of course, rolled up mostly against unknown opposition in Colombia. Larry, he's a natural right-hander who fights southpaw because he saw his brother fighting southpaw when he was growing up.
And that right hand can be dangerous because he'll not only jab with it, but he will occasionally turn it over and hook with it. That's the punch that could do some damage.
And now the royal procession into the ring for the pride of Puerto Rico, Felix Trinidad. In his last fight in Madison Square Garden, he produced by far the most lopsided defeat of Pernell Whitaker's career.
The latest in an impressive list of outstanding fighters from Puerto Rico. A couple of them are here tonight, former light heavyweight champion Jose Torres.
Hearing the chant, Tito, 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 for as long as the combat lasts.
Also here is their all-time favorite, Wilfredo Gomez, who was never in a fight that didn't end up in a knockout.
And all of the banners and placards in the arena are in some way directed at Oscar De La Hoya. My favorite, the simplest of all, HBO, standing for Heel Beat Oscar. Felix Trinidad is regarded by some experts as the hardest puncher pound for pound in boxing. 34 wins, 29 by KO, capable of anesthetizing opponents with either the left hook or the right cross or any of a variety of punches.
He has a beautiful, classic boxing style, and he strikes with both hands.
Now let's go up to ring announcer Jimmy Lennon Jr. for the official introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, bienvenidos, aficionados al box, al Coliseo Roberto Clemente en San Juan, Puerto Rico, por el Campeonato del Mundo Peso Welter de la Federación Internacional de Boxeo. We welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, for the featured bout of the evening brought to you by Don King Productions, HBO Sports, and the undefeated, undisputed King of Beers, Budweiser. This Bud's for you. This bout is sanctioned by the International Boxing Federation, President Robert Lee, Senior Supervisor Darrell Peoples, along with La Comisión de Boxeo de Puerto Rico, la Presidente Domis Delgado. Presentando a los jueces, introducing our judges, scoring this bout from ringside. From New York, George Colon. From Colombia, Francisco Hernandez. From Puerto Rico, Waldemar Schmidt. And our referee in charge of this bout, working in this his 94th world title bout, Roberto Ramirez. All right, fans, here we go with our featured bout of the evening. Ahora, damas y caballeros, presente público y aficionados del todo el mundo. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance and boxing fans joining us around the world, live from the beautiful city of San Juan, Puerto Rico, it's time for the main event of the evening. Esta es la pelea principal de la noche de 12 asaltos. 12 rounds of boxing for the IBF Welterweight Championship of the World. Presentando al retador en la esquina azul, usando calzón rojo, introducing the challenger on my left in the blue corner, wearing red trunks, originally from Santa Marta, now living in Barranquilla, Colombia. Tiene un peso de 147 libras. He weighed in at the welterweight limit of 147 pounds. Con un récord de 36 victorias, una derrota y un empate, tiene 27 ganadas por knockout. With a record of 36 wins, one loss, one draw, he has 27 wins coming by way of knockout. Ranked the number two welterweight contender by the IBF. Aquí está el retador, clasificado número dos, peso welter, introducing the challenger, Hugo Pineda. Y su rival en la esquina roja, con calzón blanco, his opponent in the red corner, wearing white trunks, y representando Cupe Alto, Puerto Rico. Pesando 147 libras, he weighed in 147 pounds, tiene un sobresaliente récord de 34 victorias sin derrota, con 29 de ellos por knockout. He is undefeated in his campaign in the ring with 34 wins, no losses, 29 wins coming by way of knockout. Aquí tenemos un gran campeón puertorriqueño y el gran campeón mundial peso welter tonight, making his 13th defense of his title. Please welcome one of boxing's exciting pound-for-pound greatest, the explosive IBF welterweight champion of the world. Demos la bienvenida al sensacional e increíble
Ok, vamos afuera.
Jim, they've been fumigating this arena for 2 days to get rid of the mosquitoes, but Pineda is here, and he is a mosquito that might draw a little blood.
Felix Trinidad with a long history of suffering knockdowns in early rounds. One of those fighters who doesn't really seem fully to have his legs under him sometimes until the third or fourth round. He's been down early in at least a half dozen bouts, but we don't know for sure whether Pineda has the kind of punching power that could affect that, although of course the 27 knockouts on his record look good. Pineda trying to work his right jab to start the bout.
From the chest up, Pineda does look like a middleweight or even bigger.
Began his career as a professional as a featherweight 8 years ago. At 167 tonight, he's 1 pound short of the super middleweight limit in a welterweight title fight. Pineda throwing most of the early blows here, although it is Trinidad who comes forward and stalks for offensive opportunities. Trinidad short with the left hand, still considerable distance between Tito and Hugo Pineda. As Trinidad tries to measure that distance and shorten it. Fighter with immense offensive skills.
Pineda is trying to use his longer arms to maintain a distance that's to his advantage, Trinidad's disadvantage. And right now, he is doing it, trying to create the geometry of the fight. There you can see Tito is a little bit short with that punch.
Lead left hook by Trinidad, about a half glove short. Pineda short with most of his jabs in this round, but that's been the most frequent offering from either of the fighters. Trinidad sticking the left hand, and you can see that the crowd will respond with overwhelming enthusiasm to any Trinidad punch. Right hand lands for Felix. Distance begins to shorten. And slowly, imperceptibly, throughout the first round, Felix has stalked and moved his feet closer to the feet of Pineda. The left hand lands inside for Pineda.
And he tried that right hook as well.
Round one coming to the close. Relatively cautious round for both fighters. Pineda more aggressive than Trinidad, though Trinidad moved forward. And as we go to the corners, where we expect both trainers to be speaking Spanish, our interpreter is former Puerto Rico resident Hector Garcia.
Calm, I want you calm. This is only a matter of time. Just relax. The jab is reaching little by little. Great.
Okay? Okay?
Don't give him any opportunity to run you over. Don't let him initiate. You go first. Even if you move back, but come back in with that straight left hand.
Well, there's good news and bad news from CompuBox for the Hugo Pineda corner. The good news is that he doubled Trinidad's punch output in the first round, throwing 54 punches. The bad news is, by CompuBox's reckoning, he landed only two of those 54. Trinidad was 6-for-27 in a very measured first round.
Yeah, that's the definition of a feel-out round.
Straight right hand lands for Trinidad.
Yeah, that right hand, Jim, landed or grazed the right eye of Pineda.
Lands for Trinidad. Pineda overshoots with the right. Now Trinidad comes back with another straight right hand. Felix beginning to show the accurate punching skills which have made him such a knockout sensation. Counter right hand lands for Trinidad. Pineda still trying to stick the jab. Maintain some distance between himself and Felix Trinidad.
By his own admission, Pineda told us he thought he would have to knock out Trinidad to win the fight. So one has to assume either that he's laying a trap here or he just can't find a way to cut loose.
First time he's gone to Pineda's body. And Tito getting progressively more aggressive as round two continues. Right hand lands over the top.
The crowd jumps up, screams at almost anything that Tito throws near Pineda.
Pineda driving Tito back with a left hand to the body. Against Costasu, Pineda had his moments. But he was knocked down in the fourth and seventh rounds, and eventually the fight was stopped in the 11th. One of the most interesting notes from the Zhu fight is that Pineda had a lot of trouble finding Zhu, a lot of trouble landing against him, and Zhu is not regarded as a particularly elusive defensive fighter. Now Pineda banging the right hand against Tito's left shoulder. Straight left hand by Pineda was blocked by the right glove of Trinidad. Now Trinidad snakes his right hand up the middle against Pineda.
From what I've seen of Trinidad in most of his recent fights is that he has tightened up his defense. Fighters who are big punchers often leave themselves open and get knocked down. Lately, that hasn't been happening to Tino as much as it happened early in his career.
Again, calm down. At any time now, you're going to come inside. Pay attention to this guy. Relax. We're going to try. We have to try to get to his body, little by little. The possibilities are there. This is the time. He's dead. This guy's dead. He can't fight it. His eyes are white. When he gets close to you, go for it.
Watch. Trinidad there, he slips a jab, slips another jab, and one by going under it, another time by going sideways, and there by going under it again.
A wildly enthusiastic corner of Hugo Pineda, apparently telling their man that Trinidad has nothing and that he's ready to go. I think that's what I heard over there.
Ready to go where, I wonder.
To go after Pineda, if you're listening to Tito's dad, Felix Trinidad Sr., who is his manager, his trainer, negotiates the deals with Don King, and has therefore become a pivotal figure in the still ongoing negotiation for the De La Hoya fight. Brilliant left hook landed by Trinidad, and Felix knows that he has hurt his opponent.
Very patient.
position. Trinidad. Left hand lands again.
Not rushed at all. Probing for openings.
Can finish you with either the left hook or the right cross or an assortment of other punches. To its collective feet. And now they sit back down.
Trinidad stalking.
Straight right hand lands again.
Finding the range.
And now Pineda punches his way out of the corner. Roberto Ramirez immediately stops in to give Pineda a chance to recover.
That was a low blow, and Pineda has his trunks on very low as well.
Yeah, Pineda not exercising the tall man's option to wear the cup. And the belly guard up around his ribcage.
Well, both of them are standing in the pocket right now.
You don't want to stand in the pocket and trade with Felix Trinidad. He's too sharp, too quick, too powerful a puncher.
Well, Pineda must feel that that's his only chance. That he's going to have to hit back with something and let Trinidad know that he just can't come in without expecting something in return.
Pineda doing a good job of continuing to fire so that Trinidad has to measure his aggression. Can't just go straight in. Trinidad with a very accurate punching third round begins to break down the Pineda defenses.
When you're inside, you set up a cup. You set up a cup and come from the bottom up. You're going to catch him with an uppercut. Just change your hands now. You're missing on top, so come from the bottom up. This is only a matter if you hit him in his body. You have to hit his body.
Here you see Trinidad landing the best punch of the fight. Pineda took it well. And later in the round, a straight right hand. Not a power punch. He sometimes shoots that punch out, that quick little right hand, almost like a strong jab.
Trinidad does something that George Foreman loves to see in young fighters. He measures his punches in such a way that they come at you different speeds. Sometimes the fastball, sometimes the curveball. Round four begins. Trinidad throwing only 33 punches per round in the first three rounds, concentrating on accuracy rather than activity. Pineda starting to throw a little more freely now in the opening minute of round four, and he pays a price for it as Trinidad lands a straight right hand across the top.
The more I watch Pineda, Jim, the more I think to myself, this is the biggest welterweight I've ever seen in my life.
Yeah, we were going down the list of tall welterweights yesterday, and it includes people like Trinidad, De La Hoya, Mark Breland, Tommy Hearns.
No, but this guy is just big all over. You know, it's like seeing a small dog that looks like a big dog.
It was the reckoning of our experts that the tallest measured welterweight of recent prominence was Maurice Blocker, 6'2". Left hook lands again for Trinidad. crowd roars in appreciation. Missing with that left hook, bounces that one off the top of Pineda's head. Pineda trying to come back. Roundhouse punches leave the opening. Trinidad leaves the right hand right up the middle. Now goes to the body.
Beautiful body punch in the midst of all that head hunting. Pineda fights him back.
Right uppercut landed, left hook landed. Pineda taking these punches well, but Trinidad finding more and more openings and landing with greater and greater accuracy.
This is the opportunity of a lifetime for Pineda. He's trying to make the best of it against one of the best fighters in the world.
And the crowd may eventually learn to appreciate Pineda's tenacity. He's hanging in there while the crowd roars as though Tito has floored him twice. Left hook to the body, and Pineda couldn't handle that one.
Spits out his mouthpiece. Looks like he doesn't want to get up.
Not going to get up. This fight is over. Felix Trinidad with a fourth round knockout on a body punch.
You saw all of his weapons. Stiff jab, hook, rights, the body punch, and above all, the patience that goes with what to me is one of the most self-confident fighters or athletes I've ever seen. He acts as though he was to the manor born. This is what his destiny is. He's completely confident of everything he does in the ring.
A calm, assassin-like performance by Felix Trinidad as he takes out the very game, Hugo Pineda, in the fourth round. I say game because Pineda was up to that point, although he didn't want to get up after taking the body shot.
He got hit with seven or eight real hard punches in that round. And maybe all of the weight he had to take off to make weight hurt him in the end when he was hit in the body, Jim. Weakened him in the body.
So Trinidad does his part, just as De La Hoya did a week ago. Whither now the continued negotiations for a possible summit meeting September 18. Felix Trinidad closing the show in round four, landing 32 of 52 punches, including 28 of 44 power shots. Watch again the accuracy with which Trinidad went about this. Right cross there hurts Pineda. And now looking for opportunities to finish. Right hand to the body, backs Pineda back into the ropes. Straight rights landing, the left just missed, but by now Pineda wobbling and unsure of himself. And that left hook to the body was all it took for Felix Trinidad to finish off a wounded warrior in Hugo Pineda. Another look from the upstairs angle and watch the body shot right here. Boom. Reminiscent of Roy Jones's body shot knockout of Virgil Hill last year in Mississippi. Once the mouthpiece came out, as Pineda was going to the canvas, he never showed the slightest interest in putting it back in. Victorious moment for Felix Trinidad. Moves his record to 35-0 with 30 knockouts. Remarkably similar to the record of Oscar De La Hoya, 31-0 with 25 knockouts. Will they meet September 18? Well, let's go to Jimmy Lennon for the official particulars on this one.
Damas y caballeros, tenemos el tiempo 2 minutos 53 segundos en round número 4.
with a time of 2 minutes 53 seconds in round number 4. He's the winner by way of knockout. El ganador por knockout, el gran campeón puertorriqueño y el gran campeón mundial, el invicto Félix Tito
Hunstadt numbers will offer testimony to the one-sidedness of the fight. Trinidad landing 53 more, throwing 94 less, and therefore outdistancing Pineda in connect percentage by an extremely wide margin. That was total punches, power punches. It was a clinic. Trinidad landing 52% of his hooks, crosses, uppercuts, and body shots. And Pineda only 16 of 91. So we called it a showcase at the beginning of the evening, and indeed it became a showcase for Trinidad's accuracy, balance, patience, punching power. And Larry Merchant, who summed it all up so well at the end, ready now in the ring with Tito.
All right, thank you, Jim. Congratulations, Felix. Did he pose any problem at all for you because of his size?
¿Él te dio algún problema por causa del tamaño de él?
No, sinceramente, no me dio problema. Yo iba con calma, esas eran las instrucciones de mi esquina.
No, no problems at all. I was being real calm, and there was instructions from my corner anyways.
Were you determined here to send a message to Oscar De La Hoya with your performance?
¿Estabas tú determinado mandarle un mensaje a Oscar De La Hoya con tu trabajo hoy?
Sí, ese el mensaje él lo tiene hace mucho tiempo, pero ahora le acabo de comprobar que yo soy el mejor libra por libra. En septiembre 18 lo voy a ver en el ring.
He had the message a long time ago, but this was a way for me to demonstrate to him that yes, I'm ready for him for September 18th.
You've made it clear that you want to fight Oscar De La Hoya. There have been some problems with resolving the final matters in the contract. Are you confident that those matters will be resolved and that the fight will take place in September?
¿Tú crees que los problemas que han habido en el contrato para pelear con De La Hoya se van a resolver a tiempo para pelearlo?
Sí, se van a resolver a tiempo. Don King y Tito Trinidad, number one in the world, y queremos pelear en septiembre 18.
Yeah, the problems will be solved on a timely fashion for that fight to take place.
So you're confident the fight will take place. What does that showdown mean to you in your career?
¿Qué quiere decir esa pelea para ti en tu futuro?
Bueno, esa pelea para mí es bien, bien importante. El mundo entero nos quiere ver peleando y yo voy a demostrarle una vez más al mundo entero que yo soy el mejor libra por libra. Septiembre 18, te veo en el ring.
This fight for me is very important and I'm going to demonstrate it on the 18th that I'm the best fighter in the world.
Thank you very much.
Best fighter in the world.
Gracias, Tito. Quisiera enviar un mensaje, un saludo a mi tía en Nueva York. Y un saludo también a todas las personas que están en Vieques, Puerto Rico, respaldando al pueblo de Puerto Rico.
A message to all my relatives in New York and Vieques, Puerto Rico.
Thank you again. And back to you, Jim. I'll join you in a moment.
Yep, Larry will be here to start the drum beat for De La Hoya Trinidad in just a moment when he comes down from the ring. Right now, let's look ahead to some more upcoming sports programs here on HBO.
June 5, tune in for Roy Jones against Reggie Johnson as they attempt to unify the light heavyweight title. Jones may be the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world, but most of us believe Johnson will be Roy's toughest opponent in 4 years. Two champions, the only unified title in boxing. Later in June, Boxing After Dark has a heavyweight doubleheader. In one fight, Michael Grant faces Lou Savarese. Grant is rated by most as the heavyweight heir apparent, but must defeat the veteran Savarese to solidify his prospects for the throne. Also, another contender could emerge as Haseem Rahman and Jeremy Williams face off. 2 days later,